Our next guest, comedian, author, prolific author, actor, director, and the ABC on Twitter this morning have called it hilariously awkward. Three Summers, his new movie, the one and only Ben Elton.
Hilariously awkward.
I think they mean it's a comedy of manner.
I think so.
Slightly, you know, people being a bit daggy, having fun with that.
Oh, well, look, we loved it. The whole fact of watching it and seeing so many Perth actors, there were so many local performances in it. Did you want to keep it as local as possible?
Well, it's very much a West Australian project. I mean, it's set in the Binjara region at a fictitious version of our famous Fairbridge Folk Festival, which, a lot of fun colliding a bunch of West Australian stories there. So certainly, yeah, I mean, there's so much talent around in WA, and of course, so much acting talent and so much screen crafts talent. I mean, 91% of the crew were West Australian and at least 60% of the actors, and yet it's already being acknowledged that, you know, it's a fantastically cast film. So it is a great advert for WA. I don't suppose I set out to do that. I set out to use the very best people I could, and, well, you know, you find them here in WA, no doubt about that.
Terrific.
It's great.
Mate, lots of laughs, of course, and a love story, but you also deal with some difficult stuff, refugees and Indigenous issues, which is great to tackle that stuff. Do you feel compelled or that you have a responsibility to deal with that, and how difficult is it to write that stuff?
That's a good question. Always a good question to ask somebody who's essentially a comedian. I mean, almost all of my work, not all my novels, but most of my work is comical. But the thing about comedy is it shouldn't be reserved just for the sort of silly and the light. I mean, that can be great too. We all have a little fluffy gag. But, you know, sometimes a gag about a serious thing can be the best gag of all. You know, Charlie Chaplin showed us that at the beginning of the last century. So, no, it's not like I feel a duty to cover the big issue. It's that's what moves me as an artist, for what it's worth. I mean, you know, I'm sitting there at trying to write a whole bunch of Australian stories about where we all are in 2017, having fun with the kind of mix-up that we are in Australia. Mm. Everyone's talking about, you know, traditional Australia or what's an Australian, and, you know, the whole national conversation. So it would be very strange, I think, if that didn't touch on refugees, touch on Indigenous recognition, because these are things we're talking about. Mm. And certainly in terms of refugees, the last two elections were essentially fought on a sort of tidal wave of information and misinformation about what it is to be a refugee and what a boat is. Mm. So it's not like I've got a duty, but I just feel I'm moved to write interesting stories about interesting people. And as you say, we've got love stories, we've got silly, jokey stories, and a couple of slightly more serious stuff.
Ben, speaking of the silly and the light, I've been wanting to talk to you for 20 years about a night I had at the concert hall with the more conservative of my two sisters. You were working comedy and you were being a very naughty boy. You were working quite potty that night.
Stand-up comedy. Oh, well, yes.
It was the funniest.
I used to swear too much. My mum gave me one wonderful piece of advice that I offer now to all the comedians who are listening.
Yep.
She said, Benji, you know, the F word is all very well as an exclamation mark. It's very little use as a comma. And I think she was actually right. I think I did used to swear too much, but I make no apologies for the subject matter I covered.
Yep.
I was covering tax on tampons 30 years ago, thank you very much. So that was called a rude routine in those days. I said it's rude that there's a tax. So, you know, there you go.
Yep.
Sometimes rude subjects are serious too.
Yeah, it was a very funny night. I was squirming more than my sister. She was handling it very well. But it was, it was brilliant.
You're more conservative, sister. Well, I don't know how conservative that is. Maybe that's just a little bit less left-wing than your other sister. We don't know.
Terrific. Well, we'll get her on.
What do you find to be the major differences, Ben, in writing work in the UK? And obviously we know you for major works, not only your books, but The Young Ones and Blackadder, and to work that you've produced in Australia. Are we a bit more sort of parochial here?
No, I don't think so. Although for me, it's taken quite a long time to be recognised as kind of as an Australian artist. I mean, I do get, I definitely have, you know, no worries, but there's definitely been who are you and what are you doing here? It was even worse
That when you walked into the station. Yeah.
In New Zealand. I remember when I was flogging Stark, the first time I went to New Zealand as on a publicity trail doing, you know, Spruiking Stark, my first novel. First interview I did, first radio interview, said, geez, mate, your career must be crap if you can come and talk to us.
Oh, really?
He was being very dry and Kiwi, but you know what I mean? And certainly, obviously you don't get that in Australia, but I definitely get a feeling, I used to get a feeling of, what are you doing here sort of thing. Well, I'm here because I'm married to an Aussie. I live in Fremantle. My kids are at the same school my wife went to when she was a girl. It's what I do, and the greatest privilege of my life actually has been the chance to immerse myself in the West Australia. I mean, professional life, the West Australian movie scene, to get a movie up funded by the public. I mean, it's Screen West, Royalties for Regions and Screen Australia, because no Australian movie is made without public funding.
No.
But all our money went back into the Binjara region, and it will make money, and that will go back in. So it's an investment. It's not a gift. But it is a great privilege to be able to, you know, be embraced by a different culture, to find yourself working in a whole new land. You know, I only came here when I was 26, so I was very much, you know, British, but now I'm both. And principally at the moment, I'm Australian. I have been the last 10 years living here. So I never thought I'd finally get to the point where I'd be accepted to make an all-Australian movie, all-Australian cast, all-Australian crew, except for the Irishman, Robert Sheehan. But we'll
of course.
I don't know whether there's a big difference for me working as an artist, because I always just express myself about what I feel. But because when you see the film, I know you've seen it, it deals very much with being Australian. Mm. You know, clearly that's been a big change for me. I certainly wasn't going to write that when I got off the plane with Rick Mail 30 years ago.
No.
My life took a very strange turn.
It is a very exciting week because Three Summers in Cinemas on Thursday. And Ben, great to catch up, mate. All the best.
What a pleasure. Thank you very much.